International Women's Day is a reminder of female power. As women, often we are wallflower, circumspect and guarded in our opinions. But we have a story to tell, a lot to say in voice exuding confidence. We are the reason to be, to rise and shine, and be a harbinger of change. Yes, we are the empowered women, a celebration of life. Today, on this International Women's Day, I wish to recite a few lines of the beautiful poem, I Rise by Maya Angelou. Maya was one of the most influential women poet and human rights activist of our time. Enjoy the poem. You may write me down in history with your bitter, twisted lies. You may trod me in the very dirt, but still, like dust, I will rise. Just like moons and like suns, with the certainty of tides. Just like hopes springing high, I still rise. You may shoot me with your words. You may cut me with your eyes. You may kill me with your hatefulness, but still, like air, I will rise. Leaving behind nights full of terror and fear, I rise. Into a daybreak that's wondrously clear. I rise, I rise, I rise. On this International Women's Day, we fondly admire each woman who has challenged the world and risen to encapsulate womanhood with prodigious achievements. Thank you.
International Women's Day is observed on every 8th day of March all over the world to celebrate achievements of women in various walks of life. Today, on this day, I would like to mention contribution of women entrepreneurs who are making contribution to Indian economy. In one such example, I would like to share a real story of a woman named Navlaben Dalsanbhai Chaudhary, a woman who started a dairy at her home last year only and achieved her mini revolution in dairy farming in her village. This 62 years old woman from Nagna village in Banaskantha district of Gujarat has made a record by selling milk worth rupees 1.10 crore in the year 2020 and made handsome profit of rupees 3.5 lakhs per month. Her act has inspired many women of neighboring villages to do similar kind of job and achieve financial independence. Top to this, Navlaben has also provided employment to over 25 people of her village who are mostly women. Such small real stories inspires the common woman of today to achieve financial security, which is in fact real sense of freedom.
Hello everyone. International Women's Day, celebrated on 8th March, is a global day recognizing the achievements of women. The day also marks a call to action for accelerating gender parity. On this occasion, let's remember one of our dynamic leaders of our country, Indira Priyadarshini Gandhi, the only child of our first Prime Minister, late Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. She was the first and to date the only female Prime Minister of India. She was actively involved in the freedom struggle in her childhood. She founded the Bal Charkha Sangh and the Vana Sena of Children. In 1959, she was elected President of the Indian National Congress, and in 1966, she became the first female Prime Minister of our country. She was the first to break the glass ceiling in a country where women were discriminated in all spheres of life. She gave a facelift for the women empowerment movements across the world. Her elevation to power gave confidence to thousands of women around the world to break the stereotype and succeed in their lives. I end with a quote: I alone cannot change the world, but I can cast a stone across the waters to create many ripples. Thank you.
नमस्कार। वैसे तो धरती से आसमान तक हर क्षेत्र में नारी ने अपना पंचम लहराया है। ऐसा कोई कार्य नहीं जो नारी ने ना करके दिखाया हो, फिर भी अपने अस्तित्व के लिए नारी को लड़ना पड़ता है। आज अंतर्राष्ट्रीय नारी दिवस के उपलक्ष में मैं आप सभी के सामने एक कविता प्रस्तुत करने जा रही हूँ। नारी तुम प्रेम हो, आस्था हो, नारी तुम प्रेम हो, आस्था हो, टूटी हुई उम्मीदों की एकमात्र आस हो, हर जन का तुम आधार हो, हर जन का तुम आधार हो, इस नफरत की दुनिया में तुम ही प्यार हो, उठो अपने अस्तित्व को संभालो, उठो अपने अस्तित्व को संभालो, केवल एक दिन ही नहीं हर दिन नारी दिवस मना लो, केवल एक दिन ही नहीं हर दिन नारी दिवस मना लो। धन्यवाद। अंतरराष्ट्रीय नारी दिवस की आप सभी को शुभकामनाएं।
Hey everyone, let's talk something about us today. Today we are celebrating International Women's Day. The International Women's Day is celebrated every year globally on 8th March to honor the achievements of women in various fields. Therefore, this celebration gives recognition to those women personalities who have excelled in their own fields. Indeed, women have contributed greatly to the welfare of the society and to the country subsequently. Hima Das is a perfect example of what a woman can achieve in spite of hardships and difficulties. Hima Das is an Indian sprinter from the state of Assam. She became the first Indian woman, indeed the first ever Indian athlete to win a gold medal in any format of World Athletic Under 20 Championships. She was born in a rice farmer family in Assam and recently this 21-year-old has been inducted as DSP of Assam. At last, I would like to share a few lines with you. She is a mother, she is a wife, she is a daughter, she has a persona, she is smart, she is courageous, she has beauty, she has brain and know how to use it. She gives you life, she gives you respect, love and gratitude. She believes in you, she will nurture you, she will fight for you. She deserves nothing less than you. She is today's Indian woman.
Hello everyone. Today is 8th March and every year we celebrate this day as International Women's Day. It's a day where women are recognized and celebrated in their fields. But why is it required? When asked to name an Indian scientist, most of us can only think of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam or Sir C.V. Raman. It's not often that someone names an Indian women scientist. How many of you know Tessie Thomas or Janaki Amil or Anna Mani? Do you know? Tessie Thomas is known as Indian missile women. We all know who is Indian missile men. Similarly, Janaki Amil was the first Indian scientist to have received Padma Shri in the year 1977. Anna Mani was the first women scientist to work with Sir C.V. Raman. As rightly said by G.D. Anderson, feminism is not about making the women stronger. Women are already strong. It's about changing the way world perceives that strength. A woman is human. She is not better, wiser, intelligent, more creative or more responsible than men. Likewise, she is never a less. So wishing you all a very happy International Women's Day. Thank you.
Good morning to one and all. On this Women's Day, I will be talking about one of my idols. I'm here to talk about our first woman Prime Minister of India. Yes, you are right. I'm here to say a few lines about late Mrs. Indira Gandhi. Mrs. Indira Gandhi was the popular leader of India. As I said, she was the first woman Prime Minister of India. She served India twice as a Prime Minister, that is, from 1966 to 1977 and from 1980 to 1984. She fought fearlessly against communalism and sectarianism. During her tenure as Prime Minister, India had made a lot of progress in science and technology. Indira Gandhi was known for her leadership skills. She had firm determination and strong willpower. She was a great orator and a writer. She is called the Iron Lady of India for her bold decisions in Indian politics. And she was awarded Bharat Ratna, the highest civilian award of the Republic of India. Thank you.
History of Indian freedom struggle would be incomplete without mentioning the contributions of women. The sacrifice made by women of India will occupy the foremost place. They fought with true spirit and undaunted courage and faced various tortures, exploitations and hardships to give us freedom. Today on this day, International Women's Day, I would like to talk about Begum Hazrat Mahal. She was one of the India's first female freedom fighter, bold and tenacious. She has marked her place in history as the major leader of the first Indian War of Independence in 1857 to never surrender to the British, opting instead to continue resisting even during her years of exile. Tracing history from past, I feel blessed to be a woman.
The willingness to listen, the patience to understand, the strength to support, the heart to care and just to be there. That is the beauty of a lady. Happy Women's Day.
International Women's Day is celebrated on the 8th of March every year. It is a global day for celebrating the social, economical, political and cultural achievements of women. Earlier, there were many countries where women were not treated equally and were considered only to be at home and do the household tasks. However, things are changing now and we are moving towards achieving gender balance and a world where both men and women are treated equally. There are many women who have excelled in their fields of work even after facing thousands of challenges. So, today I wish and I hope that all the women out there should work hard to achieve their goals and be an example from which others could learn. A very happy Women's Day to all the incredible women. Shine on, not just today, but every day.
A society is better when women are not taken for granted and are given equal respect. Today's women are no longer dependent. She is self-reliant and independent in every aspect and are capable of doing everything. Women have contributed greatly towards the welfare of the society and to the country subsequently. We should respect women not because of her gender, but for their own identity. Happy Women's Day!
Hello everyone. Gone are the days when men upheld challenging roles in the army. Women are equally taking up positions of high and grave responsibilities and do not think twice to fight for the family that is our nation India. Lieutenant General Punita Arora is an exemplary example of the same. From a young age, Punita had a clear goal to be a doctor. To get there, she had to overcome countless barriers of economic hardships and gender discrimination. But with her grit and determination, she made it to the prestigious Armed Forces Medical College in 1963. At the age of 21, she topped the course. A notable and inspiring Indian Army officer commissioned in 1968. She was the first woman to secure the second highest rank of Lieutenant General in the Indian Armed Forces. Not just that, she was the first woman officer to command the Armed Forces Medical College in 2004 and the first Vice Admiral of the Indian Navy in 2005. She has been awarded 15 medals in her entire defense career, and that spans 36 years, and is also a receiver of the Vishisht Seva Medal, Param Vishisht Seva Medal and the Sena Medal. Thank you, ma'am, for your services to the country. At last, I would like to salute you, ma'am, for your courage and perseverance. Jai Hind. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. A woman gives us her entire world. So it's time to make this world a better place for her. Yes, we are talking about International Women's Day that is celebrated on 8th March. International Women's Day is a global day celebrating the social, economic, cultural and political achievements of women. As equal to men, there are numerous examples where women have participated to make this world a better place to live in. I would recall some names, which are Mary Kom, a boxing champion, Pratibha Patel, first woman president of India, Kalpana Chawla, an astronaut, Mother Teresa, a symbol of peace, Avni Chaturvedi, a Rafael fighter pilot. So, from freedom struggle to the modern techno world, a woman does not lag behind in any of the fields. A woman is an embodiment of strength. Therefore, Apex Public School celebrates this day with a great enthusiasm. Thank you.
Greetings to all. India no longer is a male-dominating society. Today, as we celebrate International Women's Day, I would like to congratulate all the women for their hard work towards the society. I strongly believe whether a housewife, a working woman, or an achiever, everyone in one or the other way has contributed to the society. Today, I would like to talk about Sri Pandita Ramabai, Pandita Ramabai was born in a Brahmin family. Her father was a Sanskrit scholar. At a very young age, she got the title of Pandita and Saraswati. She worked for the education of women and against the social evil child marriage. She opened many centers for the women's education. She worked hard and she brought out many oppressed ladies from the social evil of child marriage. This is the day to appreciate the work of all the women, those who have worked to make India a better country. Happy Women's Day.
I am the light. I am the beauty. I am the glory. The solitude, the silence, the passionate, the root, the pride, the power. I am God's greatest creation. I am a woman. Hear me roar in numbers too big to ignore. Yes, I am wise, but it's wisdom born out of pain. Yes, I have paid the price, but look how much I gained. On 8th March, every year, International Women's Day is celebrated all around the world to celebrate the achievements of women in every field. A theme is proposed every year, and the theme for this year, 2021, is Choose to Challenge. A challenged world is an alert world, and from challenge comes change. I can do anything. I can challenge. I can change. I am the strongest. I am invincible. I am women. Happy Women's Day.
I am Rahul Sharma, a maths teacher from Apex Public School, is going to express my views on the occasion of Women's Day. As you know, many Indian ladies rendered their lives for the country. Among them, Rani Jhansi, Lakshmibai, Shrimati Indira Gandhi, the Shakuntala Devi, and many others. Today, I am going to tell you about the famous Indian lady mathematician, Shrimati Shakuntala Devi. She was born on November 4, 1929. She could perform the very fast calculation within few seconds. She was popularly known as the human computer. She could perform the fast calculation within very few seconds, for which her name was recorded in Guinness World Record in 1982. She wrote many books on astrology, mathematical quiz, and homosexuality. She wrote the book, The World of Homosexual. This book was considered the first study about homosexual in India. On this Women's Day, we should all take oath to respect to the every woman in the world, as the women are the most important part in our society.
Today we celebrate International Women's Day. We remember the enormous contribution by the women in different fields. It is extremely important. We should remind together to achieve gender equality. In order to do so, we should start celebrating their achievements, providing inclusive workplaces, women empowerment. Such kind of positive steps will put our efforts in the right direction to achieve gender equality. I remember the contributions of Indian women in different fields. Geeta Gopinath, Mary Kome, Chaturvedi, Kalpana Chawla in the respective field, keeping us proud of their contribution. I take this opportunity to wish all the women of the country a very, very happy International Women's Day. Thank you.